Welcome back to my channel. So today is a very special day because it is New Year's Eve and tomorrow is 2016. I hope you guys have had an amazing year. I'm getting ready to go to a party tonight and I decided why not film a Get Ready With Me video. It's not necessarily just meant for New Year's Eve. It's really meant for any evening outing. If you want to achieve this face right here and this hair right here, then just keep watching. To start off this makeup look, I'm gonna be using the Makeup Forever Step 1 Mattening Primer and then putting on my Becca Ultimate Coverage Foundation. This is my favorite foundation that I've ever used. It's taken me so long to find one that I actually like. It gives me full coverage and is super mattening, so it doesn't make me oily. I'm gonna spread it all around with my beauty blender and we're good to go. For concealer, I'm going to use the Revlon ColorStay Concealer. It does a really good job at highlighting my under eyes because they get super dark throughout the day. And also, I use it in between my eyebrows for a nice light highlight and on the bridge of my nose. And I'm going to blend all of this with my beauty blender, as I do everything on my face. So I'm gonna put some in between my eyebrows, like I said before, down the bridge of my nose, also on my Cupid's bow, and on my chin to give it a nice center highlight. Now to set everything that I just concealed on my face, I'm going to use the Kat Von D Shade and Light Contour Kit. This is honestly my favorite contour kit I've used so far. I love it. I'm gonna use the top middle color to set all of my concealer so it stays throughout the day. Now to contour, I'm going to use the bottom left color. It is a light brown just to kind of give it a nice base for my contour so I know where my jawlines are. I'm using this e.l.f. brush that I don't know what style it is, but any brush like this works for contouring. You just have to blend really well with it. After I'm finished blending the base color of my contour, I'm going in with this brown, more bronzy color from the kit. It is the bottom middle kit. It's a nice natural color, so it looks a little more natural. I try not to make my contour too harsh because I don't want it to look fake looking. So now I'm going back in and blending it with the banana color. Now I'm using my blush from CoverGirl, and I'm mixing it with the color Millennial from my Stardust by Vegas Ney Too Faced palette, and it creates a really nice peach natural color, which I love. I don't like it to be too pink, so this is perfect. Now to highlight, I'm using the Supermodel Super Shock Shadow from ColourPop. This is amazing. I am obsessed. Creates amazing highlight and everything. I'm putting it down the bridge of my nose and on my cheekbones pretty high. Now I'm using the Makeup Forever Translucent Powder to set everything on my face, especially under my eyes and the middle part of my forehead. Now for eyebrows, I'm using the Milani Soft Brown Eyebrow Gel and using the brush that came with it. This is so amazing. It stays on all day. I used to use eyeshadow and it always fell off and created this smudgy type look during the day, which was not cute, so I decided to switch over and try gel eyebrow stuff, and it ended up working a lot better and it stays on throughout the day and it's just amazing. Prime my eyelids, I'm using the Too Faced Shadow Insurance Anti-Crease Eyeshadow Primer and putting that all over my lids. Then I'm using some Scotch tape for from the end of my eyelid all the way up to the end of my brow, so it creates a nice sharp line for when you put your eyeshadow on. Now I'm using the color Millennial to start off with my eyeshadow. I'm putting it all up in my crease. I'm blending it all out with my MAC 239 eyeshadow brush and just really, really blending it because this is the lightest color and you want to make sure it's all blended before you put on darker colors. Now I'm taking the color Punk from my Gwen Stefani palette from Urban Decay and blending that all in my crease with my IT Cosmetics crease brush and just really also blending this color out too because it is one of the base colors that I'm using and you want to make sure it looks perfect and really aligned with the lighter base color that you're using. Now we are going to peel off the scotch tape that was on our face and start going in on the bottom lash line with the same Punk eyeshadow from my Gwen Stefani palette. And the brush that I'm using is the Sephora Angled Liner brush. Now I'm going back in with the Too Faced Eyeshadow Insurance Anti-Crease Primer and putting that in the center of my eyelid so that when I put my glitter on, it will stay on my eyelid. Now here comes the glitter. I'm using the Glitter Dust from the H&M New Beauty line, which I love. And I'm putting the glitter on with the Sephora Concealer Brush. It is a rose gold leopard print brush because I know Sephora has a lot of different brushes. And I'm just putting it all in the center of my eyelid. I'm really taking a lot because it does take a lot to look really, really glittery. So that is what I'm doing. Then onto my favorite part, which is the eyeliner. I'm using the Kat Von D Tattoo Waterproof Liquid Liner in the color Trooper, which is the darkest black there is. And I am creating my signature wing liner, which I will be having a tutorial coming out for that soon. So you guys will know how to do it exactly like me. And this is how it looks when it is finished. So y'all can see how the eyes look. Now I am putting on my demi lashes that are super fun and super easy to put on and super natural. Now for lips, I am going to use my H&M eyeshadow palette, which you guys think might be weird, but I'm using the pink color on the palette and then coating it with my Mally Beauty lip gloss in the color Crystal Clear. Now for hair, I am going to be doing a half up, half down man bun type look, which is super easy and super quick because I was running late. And what I'm gonna do is just put half of my hair in a bun, a messy bun preferably. You can also put it in a top knot, whichever you prefer. Then I'm going to take my Conair curling rod and start just making my usual waves that I do. And I make sure that each strand is separated once I round it up on the curling rod because I want it to be wavy. And then I start twisting the ends of my hair so it creates a nice strangly type look. Now I'm spraying it with the Suave Dry Shampoo to give it nice texture and to just create some friction in between the strands, make it look super messy because that is what I intended on looking like that night. Just my hair, not my look. But this is the entire New Year's Eve look. As I said before, this isn't just for New Year's Eve. You can wear it anywhere, to the movies, any evening outing that you're going to. So I hope you like it. Thank you guys so much for watching this video. I hope you guys enjoyed it and can use it as a guide for you guys if you guys are going out anywhere at night. I'll put all of the makeup products that I used in the description box below and the key items that I really love. So make sure you take a picture of you and tweet it at me at Macy Kate Music or Snapchat me at Macy Kate Music. Make sure you guys go comment and subscribe because your girl we'll be making some more videos. I hope to see you guys so soon, and I love you, and I will see you. Bye.